Hi, Jay. Good to feel you there. So I am motivated or feeling the impetus to do a 30-day self-care container. And if you're interested, you're welcome to join me in that. And this just is what I'm seeing it as, is taking 30 days to amplify self-care. Sometimes I think this word of self-care is overused, and it feels like it's all the simple things, like, you know, take a salt bath or use essential oils, like all those, which work wonderful. But I think that what I'm finding is that my self-care is needing to be super creative and different on a daily, almost moment-to-moment basis of what I need. All the old things that I used to do, the standard things, are helpful, but I need a lot of other choices, and I'm needing to stay very alert, very awake in the moment with my choices of what I need, so that I have the energy just to simply function well with my basic daily things. So when we are under any kind of changes, like if we set goals and we've got to change some behavior, upping self-care is absolutely necessary. If you have goals with relationships, with family, with your work, or with what you're doing in the world, if you're wanting to be make a change, that you absolutely have to increase the self-care, because it's going to take more energy than what you have been doing. So with that in mind, we'll do 30 days of dancing in the morning. And you're welcome to do it anytime during the day if you want to, or just let this be maybe some inspiration for you to check in to see how's your self-care today. What are those things that your body is telling you that it needs to feel more balanced and more in harmony with love, and with feeling energized, with feeling balanced, with feeling more health, more vibrance. I was speaking with some friends of mine, and they were saying that they're finding that especially things that feel like they're purifying the body, like breath work and increasing vegetables, and what else did some of the other girls I was talking to say? Movement, super, super important. Stretching the body, super, super important. But all of these things, you know, we're in an environment that is toxic at times, and if we don't keep clearing ourselves and moving through it, and sometimes that means also resting more and drawing back and receiving more wherever we can, even with our eyes, that's a good place to play with receiving. If you blink a few times and let your eyes dampen, you know you're stressed if your eyes are burning, and they're that's a sign of fatigue and stress. But if you blink your eyes and then move them right and left and up and down and then around a few times, it's really helpful to stretch the eye muscles and will help eliminate sometimes the tension in the head and the neck, and even the fixed point of view can happen from having our eyes on one thing all the time. So if we start to look around our surroundings and not assume that we know where everything is or what colors things are or what it looks like, if we don't assume it and we just take a moment of receiving and letting what you see come in versus looking for an answer, but letting it come in, it can be very restorative, not just for the eyes and the head and the neck, but also to your mind. So that's today's tip. Okay, so I'm ready to put a song on. It'll be a short dance today. I'm driving my kids into school. We are not used to the school schedule yet. This change from summer to fall is rough, and we're all like that. So dancing helps. Here we go. Thank you. Good morning, Miss Kim. I'm going to take a moment to breathe and take this dance in and then head out to my day. I hope you have a beautiful day, everybody. Get a little dance in, a little self-care. I'll see you tomorrow morning, probably about the same time, or maybe a little later. Maybe I'll be able to sleep in a little. Yeah, right. Or not rush. Shake it off. Bye.